Hi, this is Jim Lipuma of the New Jersey Institute of Technology, recording for my technical communications class. This material comes from my text, Fundamentals of Undergraduate Education and Learning, and today's topic is technical communication. So far, we've discussed many different conceptions of communication, and now we want to delve a little bit deeper into a more specific concept dealing with this class, which is, what is technical communications? For us, it's a form of communication dealing with specialized content, format, methods delivery, and needs of the target you're seeking. Though all kinds of communication can benefit from what we're talking about, this course, as it unfolds over the next few lectures, will really begin to look at different aspects of the concepts put forth here. Now, generally, many people think of technical communication as expert knowledge being translated to a general audience, but this isn't always true. Any kind of specialized communication task in which you need to use a specified form, meet a specific kind of content, deliver something to a target in the way they want, or meet the needs of a target as specified could be considered technical communication. Many times, your resume is one of the first places where you will encounter a technical communication situation needing very specific rules and guidelines to be followed. Now, one thing that you want to think about is that you have to expect the sender to think about the package and tailor it so that it meets the needs of that situation. This is what technical communication will hopefully assist you to do. So what we want to think about is, as you make that package, there's three major areas to consider. There's goal, target, and situation. At the beginning, these are the central concern for the sender. This will not guarantee that your package will work, but as you work to construct your package, which is again the combination of message and medium, if you understand your goal, your target, and the situation in which the package will be used, you're more likely to create an effective package that accomplishes your goal. Now, goal. This is what the sender wants. This deals with your decisions and choices. The more you know about things, the more research you've done, the more prepared you are, the more likely your goal will be clearly specified and defined, as well as more effectively accomplished by your package. Next is target. This is the person or group of people that you intend your package to be received by. And for us, what you really have to consider is what that person or group of people need to see and want to have so that your goal can be accomplished. Lastly is the idea of situation, and this deals with the details of the experience that occur as the package is being received and acted upon. And it asks you to figure out what to expect, and with that expectation, you can then create your package to anticipate these things. The situation often contains those obstacles that we were talking about in the process of communication, and so if you can anticipate any obstacles, either interpersonal or transmission obstacles, you're more likely to create a package which can overcome them so that your target can receive it and thus accomplish your goal. So what are the parts? Again, we begin with package because package is where many people begin to craft the ideas that they want to accomplish. Sometimes the form is given to you. Other times it's up to you to choose it. Sometimes the method of delivery has already been specified. Other times you'll have to choose this. So for your package, again, it's the combination of message and medium. If we look at the goal related to the sender, this is up to you to choose. If we think about the target, again, this is up for you to choose, but many times it's delivered to you. Unfortunately, I cannot tell you what to do. I can give you suggestions about what's most likely. For example, in your resume, there are certain forms that your target will automatically expect to see in a written resume. There are certain pieces of content or message that they will expect to have in it. In order to accomplish your goal of having your resume read, and so the target will contact you, these ideas are important. Also then to the medium. Your resume is often delivered in written form, but in some cases it's to be scanned in by a computer or presented as you're speaking to them orally. These types of delivery and the medium used change the package because of the situation. And that's our last aspect. This idea of situation looks at what happens when the package is received by, opened and then trying to be read and interpreted by your target. Sometimes this is the most difficult thing to anticipate, but it gives you the most likelihood of success, because here is where you can begin to expect what the target wants in the package and make sure that there's nothing that prohibits, prevents, or in any way keeps them from getting your message. For the remainder of these lectures that we're going to talk about from now on, we're going to use these different terms, goal, situation, target, and package, and delve into their content much more deeply so that we can improve the quality of what you create to increase the likelihood of your success. Thank you very much.